Well, happy Monday to you. It's a chilly start to our morning. Let's check in with meteorologist Matt Milosevic to get you out the door. We're talking about U.S. Secretary of State Mike Pompeo, who is scheduled to speak at U of L this morning. That's where we find our Marvis Herring, who is live for us with more details about the secretary's visit. Marvis, good morning. It is now 5:02. A mother is pushing for answers this morning after a drive-by shooting at her home on Thanksgiving night. A six-week holiday celebration has people flocking to Louisville's Parristown neighborhood. Fête de Noël has transformed the area into a winter wonderland. The Horseshoe's Glory of Rome Riverboat Casino will soon close for good. It makes way for the new $85 million Caesars Southern Indiana. A LaGrange man accused of shooting and killing his own son is expected in court this week. 5:13 is your time this morning. Right now, police in Tennessee are looking for four teenagers accused of escaping from a Nashville jail. Two of them are murder suspects. The others face armed robbery and gun possession charges. Meanwhile, police in Wisconsin have arrested a 17-year-old student saying he took a gun to his high school. The Jefferson County School Board has called a special meeting tonight for the advisory committee of the student assignment review. An apple that could last up to a year. The refrigerator is starting to hit grocery store shelves across the country. You might want to check your fridge this morning. A Kentucky company is recalling bacon and ready-to-eat turkey products over misbranding and undeclared allergens. A spokeswoman says the 95-year-old Carter is feeling better and looking forward to going home soon. I'll tell you what.
Man.
He must know the Lord.
He was.
Because the Lord just keep on letting him hang on.
And he just doesn't sit down. I mean, he's continuing to build houses, yeah. And he has the bandage and...
Hey.
He just wants to keep working.
Well, Mr. Carter, put in a prayer for me, because literally you are Jesus' homeboy.
Right?
Yeah, police say the boy was trying to cross a busy two-lane highway when he was hit and killed by that car. Our Carrie Grace is live at Silver Creek Middle School, where that student attended. Carrie, how is the school handling this today? Thanks, Carrie. The man arrested in connection with a deadly shooting outside a Radcliffe Walmart is due in court this morning. Comes after House Democrats on the House Intelligence Committee released a scathing report claiming President Trump committed serious misconduct. Our Jared Hill is live in Washington. And Jared, what can we expect today? Opening today, Metro Police Chief Steve Conrad will testify before the Metro Council Public Safety Committee, all to talk about the latest reorganization for LMPD. A disturbing story out of Bowling Green this morning. Three people are facing charges accused of selling and buying a baby. Maria Domingo Perez is accused of selling her child for adoption. Police say they were first tipped off from officials at an elementary school. Officers say the baby was born in October and Maria tried to sell the infant for $2,000. But instead of turning them over to the cops, he's now changing their lives. Barry Washington owns Barry's Cheesesteaks and More. A month ago, he saw six teens throwing bottles at cars near 2nd and Oak Street. Instead of yelling at them or calling the cops, he offered the boys a job. Spalding's University's president is looking back on the journey 20 years ago that made her the first woman to ever row across the Atlantic. Tori Merton McClure was also the first American to successfully complete the 3,000-mile feat without any help.